to call upon a person who has been graduated in medicine from Baroda Medical College, MS University, Baroda, Gujarat in 1988, got his MD in internal medicine from Baroda Medical College in the year 1992, DM Endocrino, SDPGIMS, Lucknow in 1994, DNB Endocrino, National Board, Delhi, a senior consultant, Medwin Hospital, since the year 1997, junior consultant, Kamineni Hospitals, from 1996 to 1997. He has been running DNB Endocrinology Training Program in Medwin Hospital since October 2005. And he has submitted paper on insulin, first national conference on Indian Society for Bone and Mineral Research in the year 2005. He had attended national conferences, Endocrine Society of India every year since 1995, Diabetic Food Society of India, Annual Diabetes Symposia, CME in Osteoporosis, Newer Modalities of Treatment Symposium. So he is our, the guest speaker, Dr. K.D. Modi. Give a big hand for Dr. K.D. Modi.
Thank you all. And I thank Nageswara and other dignitaries. Actually, I am new to this quorum, so many of you I might not be knowing, but it gives me an immense pleasure to be here in a broader society serving related to medical, other medical aspect. Generally, my day-to-day work, everything is related to clinical practice, related to diabetes, thyroid, and other hormone endocrine problem. And regularly we conduct CMEs, virtual and face-to-face, but mainly related to endocrinology. So you have given me opportunity to involve myself in a broader aspect of medicine, that is a concept of essential drugs. It is a very nice area for any worker working in health related field. Everybody should know that what are all essential drugs, and this is a very broad terminology. Like for somebody, whatever you call it non-essential may be essential for him. But by and large, essential drug list, it includes that touches everybody in the society. And that is the purpose of making this list. And by making this list, we are serving so many purposes, and that we will come to know in my subsequent presentation. So flow of presentation will be like this, that what is essential medicine, why they are important, what is the WHO model of concept of essential medicine, and what is the national list of essential medicine from India. So what we have gathered from WHO module, how we have modified and how we have updated. So basically, if you see the detailed definition of essential medicine, there it is a basic health need of the society or population in target. Disease profile may differ from country to country, from area to area. So WHO has given broad guideline, and from that we have to decide that which drugs are relevant as per our country disease profile. So essential drugs it should be, yes, main, most important thing, it should be effective, it should be safe, it should be easily accessible, and it should be cost effective. So when these four purposes are served, then only in true sense it comes under list of essential drug. WHO has given a list of essential drugs with a blueprint for selecting cost effective and high quality drugs. And if you ask me to simply define the essential medicine, so essential medicine is the one that satisfied the priority healthcare need of the population. This is an in nutshell simple definition of essential medicine. And they are selected with due regard to public health profile, evidence, it should be evidence-based medicine, and it should be evidence should be there on efficacy of the drug, on safety of the drug, and it should be comparatively cost effective so that it can reach each and every part of the segment of the society. Why do we need this? We need this because each country has different, as I said, morbidity profile. And morbidity, whatever we used to call Western disease, now they have become very, very common disease in developing country. So in developing country, the morbidity profile, initially it was only infectious disease that was killing our population. But now non-infectious disease, chronic non-communicable disease like diabetes, hypertension, cardiovascular disease, all these diseases have become very, very common and main killer in developing countries. So need, like if you ask me 40 to 50 years back, the list of essential drugs would include mainly anti-malarial and anti-parasitic other drugs. But now essential drug list from developing country would definitely include drugs related to hypertension, drugs related to cardiovascular disease, drugs related to diabetes. And we spend a lot on preventive aspect, on promotive aspect, on rehabilitative health activities. So when we are spending so much, it becomes very, very important to have a list of a few essential drugs which should be accessible to each and everybody. And other aspect of a list of essential drugs is it will also exclude, it will also give warning against indiscriminate use of drugs leading to expending of scarce resources, because overall resources are also limited. And we know that abuse of mainly antibiotics and analgesics, these are prescribed so much indiscriminately. And how much is the justified usage, how much is abuse, that we don't know. So list of essential drug will try to cover the very important drugs and try to exclude other non-relevant drugs. And what are the requirements of essential drug medicines? They should be available all the time. They should be available in adequate amount. They should be available in appropriate dosage form, especially in essential drug list of India, last modified in 2015. This aspect was given immense importance, that dosage, appropriate dosage and strength of the drug should be mentioned clearly. And it should be with assured quality and safety, and it should be available at a price which anybody in the society can afford it, can access it. So, first concept of essential medicine came in 1977, and at that time it was the first model of list of essential drugs by WHO, and then subsequently it was revised, and newer list from WHO is recent in this year 2021. So 2021 list, it includes 433 drugs, and in India it list of national essential drugs started in 1996, and last update was in 2015. And Indian list of essential drugs, it includes mainly 376 medicines, and now with the newer updation, some fixed dose combinations are also allowed. So 20 fixed dose combinations are there, and Indian government has divided these essential drugs in three categories: primary, secondary, and tertiary level healthcare facility, which can include these essential drugs. So WHO now it is a last list, as per last list it is 433. This was in 2015, but again 2021 also it was updated, and we have 370 drugs under list of essential drugs. So repeatedly I am saying that yes, it is very important, but for multi-purpose health worker, multi-purpose awareness society, how it is relevant? So by what we can achieve by having a list of essential drugs? So basically, first and most important thing is that health worker, everybody, anyone in field, working in field of healthcare, should know about essential drugs. So at least it gives us a guideline that what training we should give, and for which drugs we should impart the knowledge to basic health worker. And that is very, very important, because medicine and pharmacology is so vast that if you start explaining everybody, anybody who is in a healthcare field about each and every drug, ultimately he will go mad. But this gives a list where he must know about these few drugs which is relevant to each and everybody in the country. So this is the most important aspect. Then public sector procurement, like we have so many central government organizations, healthcare and non-healthcare, everywhere some drugs must be kept available. So which drugs to give priority? That comes from list of essential drugs. So in that way also it helps. And even this is very, very important for insurance company. Now we know that in India also insurance field is progressing very fast, and a day will come where even outdoor sector also will be covered under insurance. So this insurance company also take guidance from list of essential drugs, that which drug they must keep available, and for which drug they have option to say no or to make it available as and when required. So this is also very important. And there are so many health service agencies which keep helping the organization. Like if some foreign organization, if they want to help one society, that yes, we want to donate something for healthcare, then this essential drug list, it becomes a guidance for them that of this, if you provide some drugs, it will be very helpful. So there are, we really don't know, there are so many important areas where essential drug list can come in picture. And government also can have a very, like government cannot monitor for each and every drug availability. But these are the drugs where they can keep watch that yes, whether these drugs are available at each and every primary, secondary and tertiary healthcare centers or not. Even few drugs are such that even PHC, each and every, at a village level also, they should make it available. So that is also very important. And this is also important for public education. Like these are the essential drugs which should be used judiciously, and that should be, it should be knowledge of the public that yes, this, these are important essential medicines and which we can have access from these agencies. And what are the WHO criteria? That how to select this drug from for the list of essential drug medicine. As I said, most important thing is efficacy and safety. And that's why any medicine which has passed this prospective randomized double-blind controlled trial, then only actually any medicine will come in market only after this, if it has gone through this clinical trial, phase 1, phase 2, phase 3. So it should have adequate efficacy. And in phase 1, phase 2, phase 3 trial, what do we check? We check mainly for the efficacy aspect and safety aspect. Because these are two most important things for any drug, that it should be effective and it should be safe. It should not do harm. And WHO also says that list of essential drugs should be according to pattern of prevalent disease. So that first only I clarified that each and every country will have different disease profile. Whatever is common in South Africa, it may not be common in India. That may not be relevant in other country, European country. So each country has to take into account their disease profile. Then a very important aspect as per WHO guideline is a cost effective ratio. It is a major consideration, cost effective ratio. And it's comparative, and if medicines are available as biosimilar or generic, then it should have comparative pharmacokinetic properties. The company or any pharma company should prove that yes, pharmacokinetic and pharmacodynamic aspect are similar to original drug. And by and large, single drug compounds are included, but now with modified list, some fixed dose combinations are also included, especially when combination has proven its benefit over single drug therapy in therapeutic area. So this is how a list of common disease is prepared after a clinical guideline, after a list of essential medicine from national formulary, after training and supervision and looking after this financial aspect. And in WHO list, mainly there are two groups, the core medicine and supplementary medicine. So core medicines are like most effective, safe and cost effective medicine for priority conditions. While complementary medicines, it includes the medicines for priority disease for which specialized diagnostic or monitoring is required. So that comes under complementary list. And this was like, as I said, updated in 2021 WHO model of essential drug. And what about our national list of essential medicine? National list, as I said, it was last modified in 2015, and the most important aspect in this update was that dosage and strength of the drug should be given importance. The first national list of essential medicine, it came in 1996, and then last one, current one, is 2015. And main thing, as I said, in what are the important aspect of recent this national list of essential medicine is that few fixed dose combinations are also given inclusion in this, and strength and dosage of medicine very neatly, clearly it should be deliberated. This aspect has been given importance. And according to our newer 2015 national list of essential medicine, the drugs are divided into primary, secondary and tertiary essentiality at all these three levels respectively, and total 370 drugs are included. Of these 370 drugs, 181 drugs, they come under all three, primary, secondary and tertiary level. 106 medicine, they fall under secondary and tertiary, while 61 medicines are categorized at as a tertiary level medicine only. So that means these 61 drugs need not be kept at primary and secondary health centers. And so this is says the same thing, and it is beyond the scope to elaborate on each and every medicine included in this list of national list of essential drugs. So mainly I will say few drugs related to my specialty. So some injectable anesthesia drugs and local anesthetic drug, then hormone. Among hormones, fludrocortisone and hydrocortisone. See, even though they write that hydrocortisone is included as a essential drug, hydrocortisone injection you will find anywhere, but hydrocortisone tablet you will find it very, very difficult. So whatever is mentioned is not still implemented. Actually, there are so many diseases where we need hydrocortisone tablets, and our patients, they really find it difficult to get it. Only one company is there in India that produces, manufactures hydrocortisone tablet, even though it is mentioned in list of essential drugs. And complementary list includes testosterone injections that is freely available, 100 mg and 250 mg, and estrogen, progesterone tablet and progesterone preparations, and even insulins are also included. And not only that's a regular insulin, human insulins, but analog insulins are also included, because they also have become part and part of common diabetes management. Like any patients who has diabetes, we regularly use insulin analog, basal analog and rapid acting analog. So they are also included in a recent list. And oral drugs are also hypoglycemic drugs like sulfonylurea, newer drugs like DPP-4 inhibitors and SGLT-2 inhibitor like dapagliflozin, empagliflozin. All these are included in a newer list. And thyroid medicines also, though propylthiouracil is mentioned here, but propylthiouracil we use only in first trimester of pregnancy. Otherwise, we don't use. We generally use carbamazole only because of better safety profile of carbamazole. So all these things we should keep in mind. And this is dexamethasone tablet and injections are also included, and they are freely available. So what I want to convey is that yes, list is a ideal thing, but we should try to make this list in a really active and really practical in day-to-day life. And that is implementation is very difficult. So to conclude all this essential drug concept, it came in 1975, and WHO has given this concept of a modern, evidence-based, cost-effective, and I would add safe and easily accessible healthcare medicines. The challenge is to regularly update this list, and in light of new therapy, because medicine is dynamic, it keeps changing. So our last list was in 2015, but it needs to be updated regularly, and there is also need to fill gap in, as I said, in form of availability, accessibility, and affordability of medicine to poor society. Thank you very much.